This is what it looks like in some places around the country this morning, especially in the Midwest. This particular shot is from Cleveland, Ohio, where they're getting some lake effect snow. In some places here in the Susquehanna Valley, they got a taste of snow as well. Dree Anderson is here with our forecast. I saw some flurries on my way in, some ice on the roadways a little bit.
Yeah, some spots absolutely a little bit slippery this morning, even a little dusty in spots. We were just looking at the Midwest. That was Cleveland in Ohio. They got 5 to 6 inches of snow.
Wow.
But then just to the northwest up in Erie, only an inch. That's how it works with lake effect snow, hit and miss stuff. And that was the case here in the Susquehanna Valley. Let me show you over the last 18 hours. I'm starting our satellite and radar view at around noon and looping it from there. You can see out to the northwest in Pennsylvania, good amount of snow falling down. But again, only about an inch or two there. For us in the Susquehanna Valley, just about a trace picking up. We did see some of those flurries and some of those higher spots and the higher elevations as you head up towards State College. They did see a little bit more than a trace of snow, but officially not much more than that. I did see that York had 0.01. That's barely even a dusting or a coating on the ground. Here's over the last 6 hours. Closer view of the Susquehanna Valley. We did have some flurries just a few hours ago. They have now departed. We're going to take a live look at Super Doppler 8. I want to show you that it's all quiet in the Susquehanna Valley at this point. Now, there are some flurries well out to the west at this point, but they are also dissipating, starting to weaken. So I wouldn't be surprised if they don't make it over the mountains. We may see one or two more, just very quick, light snowflakes sneak by in a spot or two. But otherwise, at this point, we are dry from here, and we're staying dry. So we take a look at what I call the vertigo shot, looking down into the square in Lancaster. No snow showing up there, and no more flurries. Just an hour ago, saw some flurries on this sky cam there. It is 28 degrees right now, certainly cold enough to let those flurries sneak to the ground. Winds coming from the north-northeast at 7 miles per hour. It was that persistent northwestern airflow that brought in some of that lake effect flurries for the Susquehanna Valley. So 27 in Lancaster, about 28, 29, 30, depending upon where you are this morning. So another cold start to our Sunday morning. We're going to keep around the clouds as a result of that cold northwest airflow for the morning. But that disturbance that did bring some of those flurries is departing. So from here this afternoon, we see more sunshine as we go to York County for your News 8 Storm Team forecast. Staying cold, temperatures not getting out of the 30s. I had a suspicion we'd stay in the 30s today, and that will be the case. Then tonight, the skies will start out mostly clear, then turn clear by Monday morning. Temperatures pretty chilly with those clear skies, 22 to 28, so another cold morning. Winds picking up just a little bit from the southwest toward daybreak. It will be a little bit breezy on Monday. That is some good news because those breezes coming in from the southwest pulling in some moderate air to bolster up our temperatures to 45 to 49. We'll start out with plenty of sunshine, but then for the afternoon, clouds increase ahead of a low pressure system that will bring us just a few showers for Tuesday. On the almanac yesterday, we did touch 40 degrees briefly before the temperature started to drop midday, and we only got a trace of snowfall, and that was the case, as I mentioned, for most of the Susquehanna Valley. So the cold air here, it's in place because of the jet stream down to our south, allowing this cold air to spill in, also helping that cooler airflow to come in over the Great Lakes to support a little bit of this lake effect snow here in the Susquehanna Valley. Right now, a little bit of a stalled front, leaving some snow out in western Pennsylvania. Cold front just down to our south, so we're keeping in that chilly air. Temperature about 29 right now, but take a look in New York. 11 degrees in Syracuse, only 15 in Portland. The bitter cold air staying up in New England for us. Just that cold air we've had a few mornings, but some of this milder air, if you call it mild, in the upper 30s, that'll start moving our way as we head toward tomorrow. Also moving our way, clearer skies toward this afternoon. We'll keep around the sunshine. These clouds here, really, we don't see them. Just some high, thin, wispy clouds as they pass over overnight tonight. Monday morning, we start out mostly clear. We'll keep the ground, the clear skies through about midday Monday. Then some more fair weather clouds start to increase toward the afternoon, and eventually the skies turn mostly cloudy overnight Monday. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw just an isolated shower in a spot. Otherwise, we'll be staying dry for most of Tuesday. Only a few showers as a storm system develops in the Midwest and down to the Tennessee Valley. So just a few showers from that, the rain will arrive with that storm system as it passes overhead on Wednesday. But before we get there, temperature pretty chilly today at 38, up to 48 on Monday. We're going to reach 50 degrees when that rain moves in because it's moving in with a warm front. 46 for Thursday, another chance of showers for Friday. Then the weekend, it does look dry. Saturday, 40 degrees, and I'll give you a peek beyond the 7 day Christmas. Not looking white. Mostly sunny with a high at 42. We're going to be staying cold after Christmas. And that one computer model we talked about yesterday, showing a few flakes for Christmas Eve, it says no go. So licking dry all weekend long.
Dry, but a little cold, so it kind of feels like Christmas.
Oh, we'll be in the Christmas spirit with the temperature.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Drew.